Hi, I'm Lauren. Today I'm going to show you how to use Visual Studio's Integrated Terminal for Linux development. The Integrated Terminal allows you to interact with your Linux machine without ever leaving Visual Studio. It acts the same as if you were to open a terminal on the Linux machine your project is building on. Let's get started. I have already opened my project that's targeting my Linux machine. I'm going to click View and Find Terminal to open the Integrated Terminal. I want to open a terminal that's connected to the same machine that I'm building my project on. I can see up at the top of Visual Studio which machine my project is connected to. I could also right-click on the project in the Solution Explorer and click Properties. From the Project Properties page, I can look at the Remote Build Machine property to see which machine my project is building on. In the Integrated Terminal window, I'm going to click the Connection dropdown and select the same machine as my project's Remote Build Machine. I now have a terminal connected to my Linux machine. Let's look at some examples as to how this can improve my developer workflow. It's common to need new or updated packages from the System Package Manager on your Linux machine. Instead of logging into my Linux machine using a remote platform such as Azure or using the physical machine, I can simply use the Integrated Terminal. I'm going to install GCC on my machine so I can build my project. I'll type sudo apt install GCC. Once the installation is complete, I can type gcc --version and see my machine is ready to build using GCC. The Integrated Terminal can also display color and indentation, just as your terminal would. To show this, I'll be running a Linux package called PonySay, which prints out My Little Ponies. I'll type PonySay Hi Linux Users, and we can see that the Integrated Terminal perfectly formatted a picture of a pony. Visual Studio has a great debugging experience, but sometimes I need more than just a debugger to resolve my issues. Let's take a look at my code. The goal of my code is to open my file foo.txt and print out the contents, but currently, when I run this, nothing is printed out. I can debug it using Visual Studio's debugger and see I'm never entering inside my if statement. This tells me that I'm not able to open the file. My first thought is to check whether my file path is correct. I'm going to use my Integrated Terminal and type find $pwd --name foo.txt. I can see from the output that foo.txt does exist, but I haven't included the full file path. So I'm going to replace the file path in my code with the one that the Integrated Terminal gave me. After running again, I can see the code is still not printing anything because the file is not getting opened. My next step is to check the permissions of the file. In the Integrated Terminal, I'm going to type ls-l and the full file path. I can see I don't have read permissions for this file, which is why the file is not getting opened. I'll change the permissions of the file and double check I have read permissions. Now I will rerun my program and see that my program works correctly. I can also find the .out file from the Integrated Terminal and run the program from the terminal and see that I get the same output.
Thanks for watching, and let us know in the comments how your experience was using Visual Studio's Integrated Terminal. Be sure to subscribe so you can stay up to date on all the Linux features within Visual Studio. Happy coding!